Assalamualaikum and hi to our lecturer Professor Madya Dr. Muhammad Khair bin Muhammad Nur. In this video, we will be discussing about the group project of solid mechanics 2, which is the application of buckling of column. Next, I would like to introduce the members of group 4. Firstly, our group leader is Nurul Izzah binti Muhammad Sofi. Next, Darwin Darren anak lelaki Arumugam, Muhammad Hadilah bin Muhammad Ali Hanapiah, Muhammad Akmal Hanif bin Azman, and lastly Nur Shafina Izzati binti Muhammad Amran.
For introduction, solid mechanics deals with the deformation and movement of solid materials under the influence of force. Stress, strain, and failure of solid materials and structures are primarily physics phenomena. Solid mechanics theory is used to explain the natural occurrence of stress, deflection, deformation, and fractures of solids. Solid mechanics have a wide range of uses in the real-world application. One of that is walking can. The over amount of body weight force may affect the walking can. In this research, we learn how much of force should apply to walking can, and also we choose a suitable material for that. And then we present calculation from the topic buckling of column, which is related in solid mechanics too.
Alright, on the calculation, we need to find the max stress of the column and determine whether it can be used suitable as a cane. Alright, now we are gonna list all the information we can get to use on our formulation. Alright, first, the Young modulus is 100,000 megapascal. The outer diameter is 0.021 meter. The inner diameter is 0.019 meter. The length of the shaft is 850 millimeter. The mass used by the mass user is 130 kg, and the load exerted on the column is 0.041 meter. Alright, now the max stress formulation is sigma max equal P over A times 1 plus E C K square secant L per K times root of P over E A. So before we find for each part, for we need to list out the moment inertia, cross-sectional area, and the force, because it is we will be used in our next part. Alright, for the initial moment inertia, the we use this formulation because our cane is hollow shaft, so we got I equal with 3.14945 times 10 power of negative 9 meter power of 4, and for our cross-sectional area is 6.2832 times 10 negative 5 meter square. Alright, for the force, we use mass time with body weight support, which is the 25%. So we get the force exerted on cane is 380.83 newton, which equal to 0.318 kilonewton. Alright, now we continue to the next part, which is we find for each P over A, EC over K square, and LK times root of P over EA. We will use the I and A, also P value, in this calculation. Alright, for the P over A, we get 5.061 megapascal, while the EC over K square is equal as EC over I over A. So we get the value for EC over I over A is 8.5885. Alright, now we head to L over K times root of P over EA. We will get the value of it is 1708.24. Alright, now after we find the value, we will put the value into our formulation, and we will get for each P over A is equal to 5.061 times with 1 plus 8.5885 secant of 1708.24. From here, we just solve the equation, and we find that our stress max is equal with 66.59 megapascal. However, the stress allowable for the material we use is equal with 65.51 megapascal. So we can conclude is the allowable stress is smaller than max stress. Okay, so we gonna find the percentage differences on this value of stress, which is we use formula theoretical calculation minus experimental calculation over divide by theoretical calculation times 100%. So we just put the theoretical calculation we get is 66.59 minus the experimental calculation, which is 65.51, and over with the theoretical 66.59, and we times it with 100%, and we get 1.62% of differences.
And I will talk about calculation simulation. To determine the buckling of gain, we have made two simulation using two program. The first program is Excel. We use Excel buckling program that was developed by an organization called MIT Corp. We use this Excel to prove our secant formula calculation. So the first step is we set the feature of the cane, which is Vn. Then we set the column profile to tube or hollow tube. Then we input the inner diameter and outer diameter value. And from this, the Excel will auto-calculate the moment of inertia and the area. Then we put in the cane's material, which is carbon fiber. We put in the modulus of elasticity and the yield strength. But since we want to prove the secant formula, the material properties can be neglected for now. Then we set the column length and the axial load applied. From here, we set it at 850 mm for length and 300 N for force. Then Excel will calculate it automatically, and we get the max stress value is at 65.5 megapascal. From here, we will compare the calculation made by Excel with our manual calculation. Then for the second simulation, we have used SOLIDWORKS 2017. We use this SOLIDWORKS to determine the cane's buckling shape under maximum stress. First, we will design the cane and set the metal to carbon fiber. Then we will open the buckling simulation feature. We set the applied axial load, which is 300 N, and then we set the feature, which is fixed end at the face of the bottom of the cane. Then we run the simulation, and we will get the shape of deformation or buckling under the maximum stress, like this figure from here to here.
Assalamualaikum and hi. I will be continuing the presentation with the result and discussion part. After the discussion about the five real-world applications listed, the buckling of column of secant formula is chosen for the application that need to be discussed in this project, and the application is about the walking stick. Walking sticks are known for their aim of aiding unable people in walking. A cane is long, slender walking stick with a hand grip at the end. The use of a cane has grown increasingly important, particularly for persons who are unable to walk properly and cannot entirely rely on their leg strength. Thus, the application focuses on weight groups ranging from 70 to 130 kg. Then, the weight has been narrowed down to 130 kg. The hollow walking stick used in this study has an inner and outer diameter. Therefore, carbon fiber was chosen as the walking stick materials because it is widely used in the manufacture of walking sticks and is recognized for being a lightweight material. Based on the study, we could see the state of the cane buckling when an eccentric force is applied. This can be achieved by applying the secant formula, so the maximum and allowable stress values can be calculated by using the general equation of secant formula. Next, the formulation involved in the secant formula to complete the calculation is maximum stress, moment of inertia, the area of the circular tube, and the effective length.
Continue with result and discussion on the next part. From this table, we have made a comparison between the result that we get from the manual calculation and by simulation. So, there are five components that we compare about, which is moment of inertia, area, percentage of body weight transfer, and maximum stress. So, from the table, we can observe that the value of moment inertia, area, percentage of body weight transfer have the same value between manual calculation and simulation. But on maximum stress, they are slightly different on manual calculation and simulation. Which on manual calculation, we get about 66.59 megapascal, and on simulation, we get 65.51 megapascal. So, why is this happen? Is because on the simulation system, they are considering about the limiting slenderness ratio. But there is no limiting slenderness ratio to be considered in manual calculation. So, when we try to calculate this value in the percentage error, we get about 1.62%, which shows that the differences did not give a huge impact. Other than that, we also run a simulation by SOLIDWORKS, which we can see that the first picture shows the original state of walking stick, while another one shows the walking stick on the buckling stick. Even though there is difference value of maximum stress applied on the walking stick, but it did not failure the walking stick to function at its ease.
Okay, now for the conclusion. From this research, we managed to learn about five real-world problems, which are buckling of column of secant formula, thick wall pressure vessel, buckling of railway track, buckling of front bonnet stand, and deflection along the bridge. We can also find the real-world application of buckling of column, such as beam, overhead traffic light, walking cane, and many more. Walking cane is a device that improves our balance as we walk or help us to compensate for disability. It is not designed for full weight support, but it's only help with balance. In this report, we shows how much of average body weight must be supported through a walking cane. And also, we as a team choose the carbon fiber for the material. Carbon fiber is one of the lightweight and strong material. Other than that, for recommendation, we should know how to choose a walking cane wisely. For instance, before we buy the walking cane, we need to see the weight specification. It is to avoid the buckling of walking cane.
That's all from our group. Thank you.